60% of international packages received by the U.S. Postal Service arrive here at New York's JFK, the busiest mail port in the country. 1 million packages per day come through this facility. At this time of year, that usually means Christmas gifts and care packages, but these customs officers are hunting for something else. Frank Russo is the port director for U.S. Customs and Border Protection. His team of 100 officers is on the lookout for illegal drugs, especially fentanyl, a highly dangerous synthetic opioid that's now flowing into the country at a record rate.
So you see they're protected, they have their gloves on, have a mask on, and they're gonna open up a package and see what they find.
CBP didn't start tracking how much fentanyl it intercepted until October 2015. But over the next year, it found 459 pounds. In 2017, it found 1,296 pounds.
They'll try anything. We see the fentanyl coming in toys, we see it coming in food products, you name it, and they'll try to use it.
And what technology are you using to screen for the fentanyl?
We use spectrometry, where we can shoot a laser at a package without having to open up the package. That's critically important for our officers to make sure that they're safe.
Not having them reach the package to identify what it is that we're working with is extremely useful for law enforcement purposes. You know, for our safety, for everybody's safety. Here we go, that's just fentanyl. And this is actually cut with something else.
We've introduced canine training to detect fentanyl. And just in the last few months, they've made over 10 fentanyl seizures.
This year, Frank Russo's team made 84 fentanyl seizures, up from just 7 last year. When the officers determine they have a package that contains fentanyl, it's set aside for testing. And they have to be very careful. Inhaling just 2 milligrams, the equivalent of a few grains of salt, can be deadly.
It really comes down to training to look at packages, determine which are good and which are bad. Countries that a package is coming from is usually an indicator of high risk. Most of the fentanyl that we seize, actually all of it that we seize, is from China and Hong Kong.
In October, the Department of Justice announced the first ever indictments of 2 Chinese nationals accused of shipping fentanyl to the United States.
Fentanyl and fentanyl analogs are coming into the country in numerous ways, including shipments from factories in China directly to U.S. customers who make those purchases over the internet.
We contacted the Chinese government to ask about fentanyl coming into the U.S. and were granted a rare interview with an official from the Chinese equivalent of the DEA. The agency took our camera crew to a private mail facility where it said all outgoing packages are inspected for drugs. But Chinese officials reject the claim that their country is the only source of illegal fentanyl.
很难说芬太尼物质这种滥用或者走私贩运的情况来说，把它归结于某一个国家或者某一个地区，这是不客观，也是过于武断的。那么据我所知的话，美国很多州还在推行大麻合法化，这样的一些思潮，对于芬太尼类物质的滥用，它有推波助澜的作用。
American law enforcement officials told us the drug isn't just coming through the mail. The DEA says illicit traffickers are taking advantage of China's rapidly growing pharmaceutical industry and supplying Mexican cartels with fentanyl, which is then smuggled across the border. In New York City this year, the DEA seized a total of 193 kilos of fentanyl, more than enough to kill the city's population 11 times over.
Fentanyl is the game changer as far as DEA is concerned. It's the most dangerous substance that come across in the history of drug trafficking. Heroin, cocaine pale in comparison to how dangerous fentanyl is.
If you're able to stop one way of fentanyl getting into the country, how do you combat an emerging route that may appear?
That's the hard thing. Traffickers have established routes already, and they're using those same trafficking routes. Southwest border of the United States is porous. There's thousands of miles of border. Thousands of trucks pass every day. There's millions and millions of parcels coming to the country every day. You can't search them all. And the traffickers know that.
Russo knows his team at JFK can't search every package. Although he keeps track of what his officers find, it's impossible to know how much fentanyl is slipping through.
Are you worried that with 80 seizures in the past, that that's just the tip of the iceberg?
From 2015 to 2017, we've tripled our fentanyl seizures across the country. When we seize fentanyl, it's going to every corner of the United States. It's everywhere.